I'm here with boxing great Lamon Brewster at the Fortune Gym in Los Angeles. And today we're going to ask him an important question. Who are the 10 most exciting fighters in the history of boxing, according to Lamon Brewster?
Exciting? First and foremost, I would say Sugar Ray Leonard.
Why?
Because he was so lightning fast, explosive. He could box, he could fight on the inside. I mean, he ran his hands, you know. Exciting, Meldrick Taylor, Mike Tyson.
Roy Jones Jr.?
Heck yeah, Roy Jones, because explosive fighters. You know, Julio Cesar Chavez, you know what I mean? I mean, you talk about exciting. I mean, like, I remember being at Mike Tyson fights when everybody's wearing Versace. We in the MGM just waiting. Every girl there was, like, looking for that husband. And I mean, I've never witnessed that in my life. Like, everybody from the ghetto was like, look, we coming to support Mike Tyson. And, you know,
but those fights with 17 seconds, 32 seconds, 2 minutes, yeah, one round.
It was so much excitement. It was so much excitement because here was a man who we felt that we could communicate with. He wasn't one of those guys that had this air about him and you know what I mean? Mike was the type of dude that, from my own personal experience, is like, he see you, hey, how you doing? The same way you would embrace him, okay, he would embrace you.
Why is it that when I'm around Mike Tyson, I always get a vibe that he's about to snap any second?
No, man.
I met him five times.
Well, because the media...
The image?
Because the media have built him up so much over the years to impression our minds that's how he is, that when we see him, you know, first of all, he's a man. And when you see a man that looks like a man, you supposed to feel like some type of intimidation. You ain't supposed to feel like he's soft. You supposed to feel like I'm going to respect his face. You know what I mean?
No, he's going to crack a joke, and then he's going to be really mean.
That dude is silly, man. Hey, man, what was the movie he did?
Hangover.
I mean, that personified the type of person he was. One minute he's serious, next minute he, you know what I mean? Well, that's just Mike, man.
Did you ever spar him?
No, I never sparred.
Would you want to?
Well, yeah, I would have. Sparring, yeah. Not fight. I wouldn't fight him. I wouldn't want to fight
him. I know you told me he's your idol.
Because he's my hero. It's like, how do you fight your hero, man? You know, it's like...
Today, for the right price, people would do anything.
I mean,
except,
you know,
the Klitschkos. They'll never fight each other, no matter how much you give them.
Yeah, because, you know, it's like, when you go to give your brother a Christmas present, you hand him that present, you thinking about what you did to him or what he did to you. You might put a bomb in it. How you sitting at the dinner table at Thanksgiving with your mother...
Okay.
I don't like that dude over there.
Would you guys add Manny Pacquiao to the list of the most exciting?
No.
Why?
I wouldn't. Because Manny's a busy fighter, but there is nothing... No. Not to say he's not a great fighter. He is a great fighter for what he's done for this time. I wouldn't say he's a great fighter because it's nothing great that he does. You know what I mean? It's like, what does he do that's actually great? Now, Floyd is a great fighter in terms of explosiveness, he make you miss, and ring general shit. But Floyd, I mean, but Manny's just a warrior, man. He's a great warrior, and that's my opinion.
He went through a stretch where he went through Hatton, through Cotto, where he was looking amazing. And last three fights, let's be realistic, he hasn't looked his best.
When was he slipping? When was he rolling? You know what I mean? He didn't do the technical things that makes a fighter excited, like a Muhammad Ali, make you miss, make you pay, like a James Toney get in your face. You know what I mean? That's what I'm talking about in terms of excitement. Manny Pacquiao is a true warrior, man. He's a frontline dude. He that dude, I'm coming to take you out. I hope you stand in front of me.
Speaking of James Toney, Michael Nunn, one of my favorite
artists. Oh, yeah, yeah, man. Frank Tate. Frank Tate was, you know, he was another real exciting type of dude. Prince Nassim Hamed.
Oh, man, he put on a show
couple times. The best opening act ever.
No one could top that. No one could top a flying carpet.
To get in the ring.
So when you talk about excitement, that's what's exciting, man. What he was out of the ring, what he was in the ring, you know, that's exciting.
All time first, Muhammad Ali.
Absolutely.
Absolutely.
He brought the show to boxing. There was never a show in boxing until Muhammad Ali. Wait. Now everybody wants to be.
Yeah, everyone wants to be.
But they took it to the extreme. Well, no, I ain't going to say that. They took it to. Yeah, I will say that, but I ain't going to say the names. But I'll just say they took what Muhammad Ali did to get in a fighter's head. And they in their interpretation of it, they took it to, let me intimidate a guy now. You know what I mean? And that's why boxing looks so bad, because Muhammad Ali never meant to intimidate. He meant to get in the dude's head, because he know if he upsets this guy, he can't be thinking straight when he's trying to fight him. But now these guys, oh, I'm big. Let me scare this guy. Let me show you how big my entourage is, and let me talk about where I'm from, and I'm a gangster.
And then Muhammad Ali had a great comedic sense.
Yes, he
made
did.
It funny. Yeah.
Now these fighters, they don't have comedic sense because they're too
serious.
I can say it, but then I have to fight them. But I'll fight any
of them. You can say it all you want.
Yeah, I can say it, but I'm just gonna be respectful. Lamon
Brewster for ESNEWS.com from the Fortune Gym in Los Angeles. I'm Ali Sekback reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter @Sekback.
Sekback
reporting.